Okay, assalamualaikum guys and good morning. Alright. Previously we have learned about alkane, okay, one of the organic compounds that contain only one carbon, one single carbon, means it is saturated hydrocarbon. So today we're going to learn more about alkane. So here is the difference between molecular and structural formula. Okay, so in IGCSE they love to ask you this kind of question. To differentiate between molecular and structural formula. Okay, if the question asks you about molecular formula, this is how you write the molecular formula. So what is molecular formula? Formula that shows the actual number of each type of the atom in a molecule. Alright, so you just simply write the number of carbon and number of hydrogen. That's all. This is how you write down the molecular formula. But if the question asks you about structural formula, you need to draw the bonds. Okay. What is structural formula? Formula that shows the way of the atoms are bonded in a molecule. Okay, so you need to show the bonds. Okay, so you need to draw. For structural formula, you need to draw. If the question asks you structural formula and you give molecular formula, there will be no mark for you. Understand? So if the question asks you structural formula, structure, you need to draw the structure, even itself, the name. Structural formula. So you need to give the structure of the bond. Okay, so in this case, the structure of the bond alkane, so you need to draw single bond. All right, one C, one carbon, okay, bonded to 4H, 4 hydrogen. So it is methane. So you need to know the sequence of the sequence of the carbon. Okay, we start with methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, octane, nonane, decane. Alright, until decane. You need no need to know more than decane. Usually the question will not ask you more than octane. Usually, okay. So so n butane, what is this n butane? So this is the position of the first carbon. Okay, so like I taught you previously, okay. For example, but 3-ane, okay, you should know lah what mean by but 3-ane, but 4-ane. I already taught you that thing, okay. Why propyl butane to propyl butane, you should know that thing, okay, understand? So this is I just want to show you in this slide the difference between molecular formula and structural formula. So if the question asks you molecular formula, don't give structural formula. If the question asks you about structural formula, then you need to draw the bond structure. You need to draw the structure, okay. Understand? If for the molecular formula, you just need to know how many carbon, how many hydrogen, that's all. Okay, so we move to the next slide. So in the alkanes, you have two types of reaction. Combustion reaction and also substitution reaction. So when I say about combustion, okay, when I say about this combustion, means you need oxygen. Without oxygen, you cannot undergo the process of combustion. Okay, so reactants, alkane, and plenty of oxygen. Okay, if there is no plenty of oxygen, what happened? It will produce carbon monoxide and is very poisonous. Okay, so incomplete combustion. What means by incomplete combustion? There is not enough oxygen. Okay, so when oxygen not enough, it will give you carbon monoxide, the poisonous gas, and is very harmful. Alright, so when I said about combustion, oxygen, air, anything, but it needs to have oxygen. Okay, without oxygen, it cannot undergo the process of combustion. Alright, so alkane plus plenty of oxygen. Teacher, what happened if there is not plenty of oxygen? There, it will be incomplete combustion. So for complete combustion means there is a lot of oxygen. For complete combustion, it will produce carbon dioxide. Not complete combustion, carbon monoxide, right? 1O is 2O. Okay, so this is methane. Okay, methane plus oxygen, see, oxygen, it will produce carbon dioxide and water. Okay, the byproduct will be carbon dioxide and water. So what else required? Flame to ignite the fuel. Alright, what is produced? Carbon dioxide plus water plus plenty of heat. Of course, it will going to produce heat. It's undergo the process of combustion, please. So next, they react with chlorine. When I say about substitution, okay, it is chlorine. So what is mean by chlorine? Something chlorine substitution. So one or more hydrogen atoms are replaced by chlorine atoms. So alkane plus chlorine gas. And you need UV light. Okay, and you need UV light. So what else produced? Hydrogen chloride plus hydroalkane. So look here, CH4Cl. So it replaced one hydrogen with chlorine. So let's see. Okay, CH4. So CH, this one H, okay. So CH4, okay, and then when it undergoes substitution, oh my god, it's so ugly. So when it undergoes substitution, it will become C and then one Cl here, and other will be just H. Okay, it undergoes the substitution. And it can undergo several times. Okay, so first, and it will produce hydrogen chloride and chloroalkanes. This is what we call chloroalkanes. Okay, so this one H and this one will be HCl. This is hydrogen chloride. Or in the lab, you can find this HCl as hydrogen. Hydrochloric acid. Okay, so it will produce this one. So if they undergo another substitution process, so it will be Cl and then Cl and then H and then H. We can undergo until all H will be substitute with Cl. So first, if there is one Cl, we call chloromethane. Okay, when it 2 Cl, we call dichloromethane. When it 3 Cl over here, we call trichloromethane. When it has 4 chlorine, it has tetrachloromethane. The maximum, it can be 4, okay? Because they only have 4 bonds, okay? It cannot be more than 4, okay? It cannot be more than tetrachloromethane, understand? So, in alkane, what you need to understand is the formula of alkane, general formula of alkane, where CN and then H2N plus 2, and then you need to know, is alkane saturated hydrocarbon or unsaturated hydrocarbon? How many bonds alkane have? And this one is the important one. The sequence of the carbon. Alright, one carbon, methane. Two carbon, ethane. Three carbon, propane. And stuff like that. And type of reaction, combustion. What happens if there is plenty of oxygen? What happens to the alkane if there is not plenty of oxygen? You need to know the byproduct. What is produced by that reaction. Okay, and yes, there is substitution. Okay, substitution, you need to know it substitute hydrogen with chlorine atoms. Okay, so it can undergo up until 4 substitution. Four substitution means that first substitution chloromethane, second substitution dichloromethane, 3 substitution trichloromethane, 4 substitution tetrachloromethane. Okay, and you need UV light. Without UV light, there will be no photochemical reaction, where there will be no substitution reaction. Okay, so I think that's all for now. So you need to do this question. Okay, you can copy in your exercise book, or yeah, you can just print and write down your answer over there. I don't care, as long as you do these questions. Okay, I will see after this PKP. Okay, so ethane C2H6 is a member of homologous series called alkanes. Ethanol C2H5OH is a member of homologous series called alcohol. So what is meant by the term of hydrocarbon? Okay, so you should know the definition of hydrocarbon. It contains only hydrogen and carbon. carbon. So all members of homologous series can be represented by a general formula. So general formula of alkane, I already explained to you. So ethane can react with chlorine in a substitution reaction. State one essential reaction condition. What you need for substitution reaction. If there is no we don't have that thing, the substitution reaction cannot happen. What is that? Okay, so it's draw the structure of the organic compound, show all the atoms. So this is what we call structural molecule. Okay, structural molecule. So you need to draw and show all the bonds. So name the product of the substitution reaction between ethane and chlorine that does not contain carbon. Okay, so you should know what is the product of substitution. Okay, that not contain carbon. Okay, product. Okay, product of the substitution that not contain carbon is tetrachloromethane. Tetrachloromethane contain carbon. Okay, ask yourself, is that's what you want, or another product that contain no carbon at all? All right, that's all for now, guys. Okay, we will see you next lesson about alkene. So I hope you understand about alkene, right? It's very important. And please don't forget about the reaction of alkane. We have two types of alkane reaction: combustion and substitution. Okay, what do you need in substitution? What do you need in combustion? What happened if there is incomplete? Is there no plenty of oxygen? Okay, it will produce carbon monoxide, and it's very dangerous. The disadvantage of this combustion is you might produce carbon monoxide if there is not enough of oxygen. Okay, that's all. Okay, bye-bye.